Ladies and gentlemen, the award-winning five-star worldwide Christian radio talk show, awarded by National Association of Broadcasters and a five-star awardee of Christian Music Parade, the Arising Christian Music Artist, live from Radio Station World, here's the Arising Christian Radio host, Bhaby Seve.
Sirens all around and streets are mean. If I can make it here, I can make it anywhere. That's what they say. Seeing my face in light or my name in markers found down in Broadway. Even though it seems I got a pocket full of dreams, I'm from New York. Concrete jungle where dreams are made up. There's nothing you can't do. Now you're in New York. These streets will make you feel brand new. Big lights will inspire you. You're in for New York, New York, New York.
Yeah, I'm up at Brooklyn, now down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow. I'll be hood forever, I'm the new Sinatra. And since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they let me everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem, all of my Dominicanos right there up on Broadway. Took me back to that McDonald's, took me to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like a Simmons with them pastries. Cruising down A Street, off white Lexus. Driving so slow, but BK is from Texas. Me, I'm out that Best Buy, home of that boy Biggie. And I live on Billboard, and I brought my boys with me. Say what up to Tata, still sipping my tie. Sitting courtside, Knicks and Nets give me high fives. I be spiked out, I could trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I'm most definitely from.
On the avenue, there ain't never a curfew. Ladies work so hard. Such a melting pot, on the corner selling rock. Preachers pray to God. Hell, a gypsy cab takes me down from Harlem to the Brooklyn Bridge. Some will sleep tonight with a hunger for more than an empty fridge. I'm gonna make it by any means. I got a pocket full of dreams. I'm from New York. Concrete jungle where dreams are made of. There's nothing you can't do. Now you're in New York. These streets will make you feel brand. Lights will inspire you. Hear it from New York, New York, New York.
Catch me at the Exmouth OG at the Yankee game. I made the Yankee hat more famous than a Yankee can. You should know I bleed blue, but I ain't no crypto. But I got a gang of walking with my click though. Welcome to the melting pot. Corners will they center rocks. African Bambada, home of the hip hop. Yellow cap, gypsy cap, dollar cap, holla back for foreigners. It ain't fitted. They forgot how to act. 8 million stories out there and they naked. City is a pity, half of y'all won't make it. Me, I got a plug, special A, I got it made. If G's paying LeBron, I'm paying Dwayne Wade. Three dice CeeLo, three card Marley. Labor Day parade, rest and reach by Marley. Statue of Liberty, long live the World Trade, long live the King, yo. I'm from the Empire State, that's.
One hand in the air for the big city. Street lights with dreams so looking pretty. No place in the world that could compare. Put your lighters in the air, everybody say yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. In New York. minds are made up. There's nothing you can't do. Now you're in New York. These streets will make you feel brand new. Big lights will inspire you. Let's hear it from New York, New York, New York.
Lights is blinding. Girls need blinders so they can step out of bounds quick. The sidelines is blind with casualties who sipping life casually. They gradually become worse. Don't bite the apple, eat. Caught up in the in crowd, now you're in style. End of the winter gets cold, in vogue with your skin out. The city of sin is a pity on a whim. Good girls gone bad, the city's filled with them. Mommy took a bus trip, now she got a bus. Everybody just like a bus ride. Hail Mary to the city, you're a virgin. And Jesus can't save your life, starts when the church in. Came here for school, graduated to the highlight. Ball players, rap stars, addicted to the limelight. MDMA got you feeling like a champion. The city never sleeps, better slip you an Ambien.
In New York, concrete jungle where dreams are made up. There's nothing you can't do. Now you're in New will inspire you. Let's hear it from New York, New York, New York. Yay! Good evening, everyone. Welcome, baby. And talk show. That's New York. The ball will drop in New York City. Hello, New York City. Tonight, the ball will Okay. So, welcome to the Rogue Christian Talk Show and Happy New Year to everyone. And the one that you just heard is we recorded that song, single piano, and that was my nephew. I want to greet him because I know he's. My nephew from New York, he's very talented. He just used one single piano, and of course, featured on Ronald Brooks and Linda Brown was on a backing singer. Hallelujah. So we have everybody, we have a special guest on the show right now, but I wanna welcome my co-host, Evangelist Jacqueline. Are you?
Oh, praise God, sister. The audience, can you hear me? Praise God. Happy New Year's Eve.
Happy New Year. My co-host tonight. Of course, we have a special guest tonight. It's Dr. Danny Sanova. Please correct me, Dr. Danny. Dr. Danny, pastor. She actually pastor. And she was my guest like a couple of weeks ago about world evangelism. Dr. Danny, are you here?
Yes, I
Dr.
am.
Danny.
Can you hear me?
Oh, yes, ma'am. Hallelujah. Welcome to the show.
Welcome.
Thank you
God.
So much. And Happy New Year to everybody.
Happy New Year to everyone, yes. We also have pastor from New Jersey and New York, and they're the founder of, I don't know your name, but it's a Christian fellowship, and most of the people that attend are female. Let's welcome Pastor Raquel Agapito. Pastor Raquel Agapito,
Happy
are you there?
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year to all.
And of course, our brother in Christ, always admired his post on Facebook. He didn't want to put
you.
A label to himself. Brother in Christ, you're on the show, but he is brilliant with his ideas about Christianity. Let's welcome Brother Richard here, sir. Brother Richard.
God and Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year, Seve. Yes. Hallelujah. Before we go on, just saying, I would like to thank our sponsors of the show. Self Jewelry, 8 months, my show. Thank you, Self Jewelry. Planet on the show. Aldous Known, one of the shows. Wendy's Hamburger, they have a good price for New Year's Eve too. Agency Security Alarm System, 8 months. Beat
months too. And student life insurance I have before. And also those who always, that's my endorser. You want, there are 24/7. Call 1-888-720-8221. Go to Always Send Flowers. That got my new sponsor for 2 months, Del Taco. If you want to be a sponsor of the show, write me a PO Box 40921, Bakersfield, California 93388. Again, Baby Said Show, PO Box 40921, Bakersfield, California 93388. Looking at the geography right now, the listeners, Africa, South, and North Africa, 10% are listeners. Welcome to the show. South and North Africa, India, Indonesia, Saudi Arabia, Dubai, Singapore, 15% are listeners. Welcome to Baby Said Show. Malaysia, 20% listening. Philippines, 25% listening. Liberia, 1%. And London, 10%. German and London, yeah, 10%. Canada, 20% listening. Canada. Croatia, 20%. Look here, Ghana, Zimbabwe, Zambia, Cameroon, Nigeria, Pakistan, 15% on the Australia, 25% listening, and USA, 89.5%, USA, but for USA, 89.5%. Yes. Thank you very much, hallelujah. So we'll go back to this New Year's Eve tonight. What's New Year's Eve tonight? We'll start. I know Pastor Danny has some. Pastor Danny, what do you plan for tonight?
Hello?
Dr. Danny. Yes. What do you plan for?
Yes.
Yeah. What do you plan for tonight?
Yes, we have a church, a praise and worship, and just thank the Lord for this past year and entering into the new year. It's going to be just praise and worship and spending about maybe 2-3 hours in His presence.
Okay, hallelujah.
Praise God. Yeah.
If you want to know about Dr. Danny, she goes around the world to evangelize about the Lordship of our Lord Jesus Christ. How about that? How about you, Pastor Raquel? Do you have some worship that's going to church tonight?
Yeah, I'm going to do live because some of our church members, they are exposed to the COVID-19, so we are just doing live right later on at before 12 midnight.
Okay. We'll look for that. I'm gonna peep on it. Okay. What about you? Brother Richard. Sir.
I'm here.
Can you hear me?
I'm here.
Yes. Yeah. What do you do tonight, sir? It's New Year's Eve. If you don't mind. Nothing.
Well. I guess when it's my turn, I'll know then. But it is a new day.
Yes.
We're
Evangelist
God,
Jack.
Not...
What did you say, sir?
Say, we're here for God.
Amen. And about you, Evangelist, what do you plan?
I know you have a big... I plan on just giving all the honor, glory, and praise to the Most High God, the universe, in the mighty, wonderful name of Jesus. I'm just getting my business straight and my house in order. Out with the old and in with the new. Come on, 2022.
Oh.
God, make it good.
Yeah.
Yes.
Praise God. Hallelujah. We have a lot of interaction of the old city. We're going to start with Delaware. Her name is Mary. New Year, I have a question. Whenever we do New Year's resolution, why most of the time we became failure? We promise so many things to change, but we get where we were again. any interaction with that. Welcome to the show, Mary. Let me hear Brother Richard. So she said that every time we do solution, it's not happening. Did it happen to you?
Well, I don't usually make any resolutions like that because, for one, it's not all about us. People, they are always concerned about what they want, and yet God has what he wants from us. And if we always are concerned about our own wants, then we're never going to have what he wants for us. And what he wants for us.
Amen.
He wants us to know his word.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah. Okay, what about Dr. Danny? Dr. Danny.
Could you please repeat the question because I'm on my phone and it's breaking up.
She said that every time we do New Year's resolution, we become failure. So we promise so many things, get back where we were again. Did it happen? You made the resolution and you go back to your to that whatever.
I personally, what I do, I just look back throughout the year. I thank the Lord for everything that he has done in my life. And entering into the new year, I just want to make sure that I'm in alignment with what his word is and what he's saying. So I'm seeking him, and I'm talking personally, I'm seeking him, what do you have for me this year? What do you have for the ministry? And
yes,
is that Pastor Richard that he said, it's not about us, how I can serve you this year, how I can be the feet of Jesus, the hands of Jesus, where do you want me to go? So this is the special time that we are spending.
Hallelujah. Okay. Because,
praise God.
You know, it happens to me many times. Like I said, okay, my New Year's resolution, I'm not going to eat no more Ferrero Rocher, the chocolate. And then I found out myself after 5 days, I have Ferrero Rocher. So it's like, you know, what about Pastor Raquel? What Mary said, Pastor Raquel.
Yes. You know, when we allow God to help us from our day-to-day living, you know, if we can do it today, we can do it tomorrow, we can do it the next day. That's why we live by the hour. To wait for the next new year to change in our lives, you know, it's too long. I mean, every moment it should be, a wonderful fellowship with the Holy Spirit, of course, to exalt our Lord Jesus for the glory of the Father. So it's nice, you know.
Okay, so do you think New Year's resolution is applicable to Christians, evangelists?
For me, no.
No. How about Brother Richard? Brother Richard says he doesn't do New Year's resolution. How about you, evangelists? Do you think New Year's resolution is applicable to us, Christians? Evangelists.
You're breaking up a little bit. You said, do I think that,
New Year's resolution. Do you think New Year's resolution is applicable to fellow to Christians?
The Christian, fellowship, I kind of being broke off. I think I agree with both of the pastors. You know, I heard what they said, you know, and I touch and agree with them. Because one thing, as humans as we are, you know, it's not about us, first and foremost. It's about God. Okay, and when we entering into a new year. So it's, you know, seeking his face, the kingdom, his heaven and righteousness and everything else should be added unto us. Asking for the Holy Spirit to lead and guide us. Because when we set our expectations on, like you were saying, you might say, I'm not going to eat no more chocolate this year. I'm going to do this. Then we fail. We fail a lot of times because We don't have the discipline or the willpower to, you know, stand behind what we say. So, you know, but when we let God go before us and, you know, choose wisely and do not set goals, you know, resolution goals and, you know, too far out of our reach, then, you know, we won't fail. I understand what the young lady had said. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Okay, I have a question for you guys. Okay, so, because so many people like prosperity when New Year's come. Like, prosperity, have a proper 2022. But prosperity, they're saying prosperity, right? So why they asking prosperity? And what is prosperity to you, Father Church?
Well, if you're asking me, because you're breaking up a lot, but let's go back to what we were just talking about as far as make resolution and selling, and then the first young lady talking about how it should be, you know, our not looking into the future because it can be overwhelming. Things can be overwhelming.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Amen. And so you take all bites. You don't choke on things. But the main thing is, with a resolution is, just like you said just before, young lady, about the willpower. Well, that's man's pride. When willpower comes into play, we'll realize back in the Old Testament, God would tell the people, he would say, you're going to do this and you're going to do that. And they would say, no, we won't do it because you told us we won't do it. We know better. And he said, no, you're going to do it. But every time they would say no, and they worshiped their willpower. And even now, When we have people that get online and talk about how the doctor told them they couldn't walk forever and how they overcome, that's all about pride and willpower in a man.
That's right.
So one thing you need to know is a resolution is only going to make you feel like you're a failure if you don't do it. And then you're also setting yourself up by the having that failure. Instead of learning from a mistake, because we in this world never have learned even how to tie our shoes without making a mistake. So we can't fault ourselves when we make the mistake, but we learn from it and we grow.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. That's brilliant. Okay. Talking to you about
we're talking about resolutions, but yet we're talking about prosperity now. Well, I realize myself that the greatest command is to love God with all that we are, heart, mind, and soul. I also understand that when I love him with all that I am, that his desires now have taken the place of my own. So now, whenever I go to him for prosperity, I'm not looking for my own prosperity, but I'm looking for my brothers and sisters out there to understand what I see and be prosperous through the wisdom and knowledge of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
How about you, Pastor Raquel? Oh, I'm sorry. Are you still? Oh, no, not again. Brother Richard is still saying something.
Brother Richard. So let's share the time. And, you know, I'm just telling you what I'm thinking.
Yes. That was so brilliant.
Powerful. Very powerful.
Pastor Raquel. So many people want prosperity.
Yes.
You don't really understand what is that. Go ahead.
Yes. For us who love to walk with Jesus and he, you know, he redeemed us from our sins. So it's, as you all said, that it's not about us, but it's about him. Yes, it's true. And prosperity for me is being able to understand his word and obey moment by moment. That's why you cannot do obedience, struggle with flesh and the spirit. You cannot, you know, you cannot be victorious unless you allow God to do it for you and just listen.
Hallelujah,
You know, it's just
Amen.
Like the question.
Praise God.
I have the Holy Spirit. You know, like something like this. Oh, I have the Holy Spirit. But the question is, does he have you all the time? So one day, I have to give you an illustration. one day I went to school, and Christian school where my son went, and the Holy Spirit just spoke to me that I have to bring out my $20 and give it to one of the professor in the parking lot. So you know, I thought to myself, is it my head or you, Holy Spirit? But anyway, I would make a mistake if I will just give the $20 for her. And do you know, she takes me back. She said, oh, I want to cry because, you know, I don't have a gas that moment, you know, when I leave the school. Yeah, that's why, you know, I wanted to cry. I cried and cried and cried because I said, Lord, I hope that I will make any mistake when it comes to your voice. You know?
Yes. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Me.
Amen. Praise God.
Now, let me ask one.
That was honorable. Go ahead, Pastor. Go ahead, brother.
What I wanted to say is that we're talking about the prosperity being a resolution and things like that and what people are looking at. But what everybody that's on this show needs to understand is that whatever your place is in life at this very moment, it's exactly where you should be.
Hallelujah.
We're exactly
praise
where we're
God.
Supposed to be.
Yeah.
From
hallelujah.
Of our existence. So there's no failures here. Everybody's a success. And the way that you understand this is he chooses us to know him. And until we do, he shows it. We're nothing but flesh. And the flesh on its own will never seek to know our Father.
Yes.
So it's only by the unction of his that we know him. And if you're listening to this show because you love God, well, you're a long way above a lot of others.
Hallelujah.
You're supposed to.
What about you, Dr. Danny? Dr. Danny?
Yes, I'm listening. It's awesome statements. And this morning, even I was reading the book of Joshua, and it's talking, in fact, there about prosperity. And in verse 8, Joshua 1:8 says, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate day and night, so that you may be careful to do according to all that's written, for then you may prosper, and then you will achieve success. So when we are talking about prosperity, it's not just prosperity financially. And just achieve things and have success in life, but how about the prosperity of our soul? How about emotional prosperity? How about mental prosperity? Physical prosperity?
Those kind of things are not attractive to the flesh, so that's why the most human beings don't want it, but you're right on track, sister. You're right there on track. Because it's just like you said, it's like a tree that's planted by the water with a deep root that even in the driest times that we don't wither. And
I won't wither.
When we meditate on his word day and night, that's all we can do is prosper.
Yes.
And the way that you do that is you get
Lord.
His word in you, and then you carry him with you. And I listen to the church speak, but I understand the word. And when it says that greater is he within you than he that is within the world, God is the word. And when he's sitting on the shelf, the word is there and it's mighty powerful. But when that word goes from that shelf into your heart and comes out your mouth, you're walking and talking. It's surely he is greater in you than he is when he sits on the shelf.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
And of course,
Danny,
we are to demonstrate the word, because otherwise we become religious, and religion is a bondage. Faith is a freedom. Relationship is a freedom. We have relationship with the Lord.
You're right.
We are not living by the law, but by grace. So it depends how you look, because I know some people have problem when you say that the Christians and God has prosperity, I mean financial prosperity for his children, and some people don't receive this well. But hey, we need money to print out Bibles. We need money to build up schools in Africa. We need money to feed the children, and not just to feed them, but after that to impart to them and educate them and train them so that they can go and change their society.
Yeah.
Well, that so is
money to buy. I need money to buy chocolates.
Yeah, so you can do, that way you don't have to waste your resolution. But, you know, religion is a Latin word, and the problem with society these days is they don't understand words, what they mean.
Mm-hmm.
They call Jesus Christ, like his name is Jesus Christ. But Christ is a Greek word that means anointing or anointed one. So he was anointed by God.
Hallelujah.
Just like we can. Psalm 23:5, thou anointest my head with oil. So we understand
Praise God.
Religion is a Latin word, and you know what religion means in Latin? To reattach. Well, I know one thing about God. He's never been away from me, and he never will be, so why do I need to reattach to him?
Okay.
Only for
those
I'm touching and agreeing with what the brother said, the pastor. The only way to reattach is because sometimes, even though when we rooted and anchored, the Lord said, look, we'll go astray. So he said, bring up that child and which the way they should go. Because we're human, and sometimes we will go astray. So then we have to get back, reattached, come back home, son, Heavenly Father.
We need to be reattached. But we also need to remember what Jesus said, that this generation, all generations beyond, the sign is Jonah. And what about Jonah? He did everything but go the right way, but he ended up where God wanted him to be.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Yes.
Praise God, brother.
Yes,
amen.
Yes. We got to move on, okay?
That's the sign of Jonah. You cannot make a mistake. You're always where you're supposed to be. You can't make a mistake. He's going to prepare a well for you if you think you're that far off.
Amen. You can run, but you can't hide. Look, that's right.
That's
amen.
Right.
Praise God.
Yes. For a long time.
Okay, we're going to move on because I have other people here. We're going to move on. Yeah. Her name is Su Bing Mengwa. She said, hello, baby Seb. I am looking for my father. I have not known my father since I was born. He's American. It is 2022. I would like to see him. I'm 30 years old. He lives in California, according to my mom. Is Su Bengwa from Malaysia. She's looking for her father. She has not seen or known her father since she was born. She said it is 2022. Wow. She's now 30 years old, and the guy lives in California for the father. So we're asking, wherever you are, her name is Su Bengwa in Malaysia. Wherever you are, sir, if you're listening, please respond to her. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Sis, if you don't mind, I'd like to say something to that young lady. I was the same way. Praise God. I was like a couple of months when my mom left my dad. God rest both of their souls. I was 25. I hope this encouraged her because I'm telling her my testimony, my true testimony.
Yes.
Young lady, what I did, I prayed to my Heavenly Father, okay? And I asked him, Lord, if it's your will, let me meet my earthly daddy, okay? Because whatever went on between him and mama, I didn't have anything to do with that. I was just a baby girl, a couple of months old.
Yes.
So, but God will answer the prayers of the righteous. When I turned 25, I got a phone call. I'm going to make this long story short. He said, baby girl, I heard that you're living in Alabama. You're married and you got two kids. How much money would it take for you and your husband to fly out here? And I was born in California. That's where I met my daddy. So just pray to your heavenly daddy and ask him, Lord, if it's your will. Because sometimes things that we want, it may not be in alignment with the word of God. You understand?
Yes.
So if it's his will, God will give you what your heart desires. Trust and believe.
And we have the daddy, our daddy in heaven. Amen. He's a provider. Amen.
Amen.
Okay.
Amen.
Any more additional that you can tell about her to encourage her? Any more? No one? Okay, we'll move on. Jerry.
Well, I'll tell you what you need to tell her is to believe what she believes, because what she believes will be possible. It's what the man believes that's possible to him. So if she sees that, she'll get that. because he said, all things are possible for God, and all things are possible for the man that believes. But what you got to understand is Psalm 82, he said, I said, ye are gods. So if we're gods, we are. We're created in his image. We were created from him. We have the ability to create like that. We have that ability.
Amen.
So,
yes.
And
praise
so
amen.
We're all wicked. We've all done our own thing. And he says what the wicked man expects is what will happen. And that's why you want to expect good.
Amen.
Because
that's good.
You expect is what will happen. And
Someone
he says, lean not on your own understanding, but trust God.
Amen.
And so you don't look at anything with your five senses. He said it's like we're living in a construction zone, pardon the dust. But now we look at the future, and we see the plan, and we know the end result, so we're just waiting for that day.
Okay.
Amen.
Somebody is giving me attention. His name is Sister Baby. Who's that?
Sister Baby.
Yes. Yes.
Can we have the sister who found her father to pray for that girl? And we all have to agree that she will find her father.
Go
the
ahead.
Sister,
go ahead.
Well, what two or more agree upon in heaven or in earth, the Father will give it to them. So if you believe that that's what this woman should receive, I agree.
Okay.
I totally agree.
I pray and ask our Heavenly Father
in the mighty, wonderful name of Jesus that he do for her what he did for me.
Yes, Lord,
he said we have not because
we
ask not. But when you ask from your pure heart, baby, God will give you. It's all about having patience. Patience.
Hallelujah.
And it may not come on your time, but God's timing is the best time
hallelujah.
And he will ordain it. He will let you meet your earthly daddy.
Yes.
So just look, we can agree. Father
if it
God,
never happens, he just needs to know that he's
Amen,
loved
Lord.
Regardless.
Thank
Amen.
You, Jesus.
And God
okay,
said
we move on.
Done.
Okay, guys, we move on.
I felt the prayer have reached heaven.
Okay. Washington, D.C., Jerry, he said, happy 2020. Welcome to your show. When do you think Christ will return? So many signs right now. I can't tell you. I can't tell you when Christ returned.
Just be ready.
Okay. When do you think Christ returned? Do you have any interaction with him? Washington D.C. Jerry. Well, I will just say the Bible says not even angels knows when he's coming back. So, but just be ready.
Yeah. Just a baby.
Amen.
Yes.
Just a baby. I want to say something about that. You know, the Bible said in Matthew that when the gospel of the kingdom will be preached all over the world, this
Amen.
Is the last time, then the end will come.
Yes. Hallelujah.
You will have to move.
Praise God.
You know what Jesus said about his coming? He said, like the lightning goes from the east to the west, so is the coming of man.
Yes.
And one thing I know about lightning is lightning has come and gone before I even know it ever existed. Because the speed of light is the speed that it comes. And we don't even hear it till long after it's already come and gone. So just like in the old days, nobody knew Jesus until he told them who he was. They didn't know. You know,
Amen.
Even John the Baptist. And so what we should understand is that in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, that's when we become reborn and we see that he has already come.
Yes.
And he lived within us.
Yeah, but God revealed who Jesus is to Peter. Who am I?
Yeah, God revealed it, and that's why Jesus said that only by the Holy Spirit could you know.
Glory to God.
And so Jesus said, I came for one reason. I was born for one reason and one cause alone, to bear witness to the truth. John 18:37. And he says that my Father commanded me what I should say, and those that he draws to me, I will reveal him to them. So he came to reveal the Father to us. Well, what was he revealing? He's mm-hmm. revealing that our Father is love. He's not wrath, uh-huh. and he's not all these horrible things that men want to put him as. But
yes.
what's happened is, just as God said, I sent my prophets daily, early in the morning rising, to tell
okay.
the people that they no longer required sacrifices and offerings. But then
Hallelujah.
We understand that that was a lot of money, and they didn't want to give it up. So,
yes.
so we go on to Isaiah, and he says, well, now it's time. Come and let us reason together.
Mm-hmm.
And though your sins be as scarlet, I'll make them like snow. So he tells
yes.
them again, and tells them that you don't have to sacrifice. He says that's not required. All that's required is for you to listen to me and to love one another. And so
Amen.
They didn't want to do it.
Amen.
So we go to Isaiah 59. Just look it up yourselves. And he says, I looked around and truth was falling in the streets and was being trampled on. So I said, I will put on my helmet of salvation and my breastplate of righteousness.
Hallelujah.
And my cloak.
Amen.
And I'll come and tell him myself.
Hallelujah.
So he
okay.
came and he told us the gospel is about that we have eternal life.
Yes.
That
Amen.
We're all good to go the way
Hallelujah.
That we are.
Yes.
Just like we are.
That was brilliant.
So whosoever believes.
We have more.
Just
believe oh, yes.
what he says, but you're not even going to get a chance to believe if he doesn't allow you to know his son, because only those that the Father draws to the Son can know the Son. And
Hallelujah.
That's whom he will reveal
Hallelujah.
The Father to.
Yes. Okay, we're going to move on because we have some things from the audience. Belgium, I want Dr. Dan to answer this first. Belgium Nastran. He said, Happy New Year. Everyone happy for this 2022 partying. What can you guys do to take care to those who are in need? Those who are in need of clothing, shelter, money to the poor. Pastor Danny goes worldwide visiting evangelism. Pastor Danny, can you answer that? From Belgium.
Yes. The question is how we serve, what we do for those who are in need.
Yes. What can we do? As everyone happy for 2022 partying, but what can you guys do to take to those who are in need, the one who needs food, clothing, shelter, and money to the poor?
Okay.
Because
I
know that
it.
you've been going to the poor country, you know.
Yes.
What can you do?
Yes. Mm-hmm. One of the things that we are doing, and this is through our Ascent International University, we are training leaders, pastors.
Mm-hmm.
The purpose is to train the people in these countries what they can do locally, how they can use the gift that God has given them to develop certain businesses, to generate
mm-hmm.
some form to self-support themselves and the ministries
uh-huh.
instead of eating from people from Europe and U.S. and Canada and some other countries to keep pouring. And I can give you an example. We are working with an amazing person in India, a bishop,
uh-huh.
Who's, you know, with certain small donations, but he was so faithful. And they years ago, they bought land, they started developing rice, they started developing,
mm-hmm.
you know, built up buildings and locally generating funds. Right now, he's feeding locally 5,000 children, 5,000
wow.
orphans
wow.
in
Praise
India.
God.
But not
Glory,
this, he educated, he opened school. He opened
mm-hmm.
school, and just a few years ago, he opened, in fact, nursing school that's not a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
It allows people who are not saved, who are not Christians, I mean, they are Hindus, but they come, they pay for their education, he gets the money, and he feeds the orphans. So it's kind of a very well-developed system. And this is the kingdom minded, and we are talking about wealth with purpose, and that's why God wants to prosper his children so that we can, of course, we can help them,
we can help people to start.
Amen.
We are also accountable. What are you doing with the funds that we sent you?
Yes.
How have you? Are you a good steward? Because if you are not a good steward, hey, there are so many other people out there that can use the money. And we know the parable, of course, about the talents and how that worked out.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, we help, but we don't sow into the need, not necessarily, because I personally receive hundreds of messages daily on WhatsApp, on Skype, on Facebook, asking for financial support. We help in the places where God tells us to help. And it's a long-developed relationship that we have established. And we know these people, they have literally books that they keep account of every single cent and dollar that they have spent.
Okay.
So, yes, we appreciate to when we need, I mean, there is so much need in this world, and we cannot spread so everywhere.
Yes.
But how about teaching them and training them so that they can support this and they can, and of course, I really appreciate the time here and don't want to take of anyone's time, but just one example, we helped a pastor's wife in Kenya and she bought chicken and then they have more and she said, I'm going to take ten small, chicken, and I'll give to another woman in the village. Once she has more chicken, she takes 10, gives to another woman, and that's how all of a sudden the so many people start this business, and they have the chicken factory right there, so they have eggs, they have chicken, they can make some money. So just a small example.
Nice.
Amen.
I was wondering which comes first, the chicken or egg? That's what I wanted to know. Which comes first, the chicken
because
or egg?
Favorite animal.
Yes. I'm concerned about these homeless people. New Year's Eve. It's very, very cold outside and everything. If you happen to see a homeless people, how you can help them out, you know, if it happens that you see homeless people, or Pastor Raquel.
You know what is good to put in your car? Blankets.
Yeah.
And, you know, those are kind of good that is been easily opened. Hmm. Yeah, that's what we do. We used to pass by in Queens all the time, and there is a lady there. So, you know, instead of giving money, give them something to eat, you know, and something to make them warm. Because if you don't know if they spend for cigarettes.
Yes, it's very, very cold tonight. And what about you, Evangelist? What can you say?
I such and agree with what the sister just said. It's a blessing to have blankets, you know, extra blankets, canned goods, or, you know, anything like that that they can use. Versus sometimes I give money too, but, you know, I do whatever the Holy Spirit lead and guide me, you know. And,
amen.
You know, I just let the Lord lead and guide me and just do what, you know, he leads and guides me to do.
Whether
amen. Give them blankets, say a kind word, a prayer. I always lift them prayers up, power and prayer, as well as, look, give them money, canned goods, blanket, clothes, whatever the Lord lead and guide me to do, you know. Yes.
Something valuable like that, but when it comes to money, I don't want to give money to them. I don't know why.
Sometimes I do, and then I say, because of God said, every knee going to bow and every tongue going to confess.
Yes.
You know, 'cause some of them can lie, oh, I need money for medicine. I need money for food. So if they don't do right, but that'll be on them. But God knows my intentions and my heart is pure.
Yes.
So I do whatever the Holy Spirit lead and guide me to do. And sometimes I give money. And one thing I do, the main thing I do, is I pray a righteous prayer for them. And
but
whatever I give, you know, if I give,
But Evangelist, We have discernment. There are some people that are homeless. They made it themselves homeless because of drugs, you know. So you can
Amen.
Tell who's in
Amen.
Drugs, you know. So you don't want
Amen.
You don't want to give your money to the devil, right? So that's why.
No, no, but the spirit of discernment. The spirit
yeah,
of discernment.
Spirit of discernment.
That's what I said. When
well,
we are led by the spirit, the Lord is, you know, you know, you just, I be led by the spirit, you know. And like you said,
right.
you can tell, you know, some that's
mm-hmm.
on drugs. You know, but
yeah.
I don't try to premature judge anybody, but it's all types
yeah.
of different homeless people. Some is like the storms just went through. Some people are
mm-hmm.
in all the six nations, you know, states. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
They lost their home because of the hurricane or the tornado
mm-hmm.
or whatever it was. So,
yeah,
you know,
mm-hmm.
and it's a lot of homeless people due to that. But, you know, you just have to let that spirit of discernment lead and guide you. Then you will be
yes.
able to tell and do what the spirit
right.
lets you to do. But the main
yes.
thing I do... Before I give a dollar or a blanket, anything, I pray for them. Lord, you know them when I don't know them. And whatever the situation is, God, look, you will supply all they need. And let them, look,
Amen.
Give a testimony. Hey, well, God will get the glory
yes.
for their story.
All right.
Mine.
Say something, Brother Richard. Can you say something?
Okay, well, here's what I'm going to say. I'm going to say that God said, labor not for the meat that perishes. And he says...
Mm-hmm.
The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Have we got people that
mm-hmm.
are wanting?
Amen.
What's the problem there? I also understand that the wisdom and knowledge of God is greater
mm-hmm.
than, or better than the finest gold and jewels and rubies, far better than any riches you can find on the earth. So
Amen.
We're to labor
Hallelujah.
Not for the meat that perishes. Says man cannot live by bread alone, but
mm-hmm.
by every word that proceeds forth from the mouth of God. So we
yes.
things, and what do we see?
Hallelujah.
We see that it says we're to labor for that treasure in heaven. But then what we don't understand, because we're not told, it says clearly, 1 Corinthians 10:24, work for another man's wealth and not your own. And
yes.
Philippians 2:4,
Amen.
Concern
uh-huh.
yourself
with knowledge.
The cares of others. So
yes.
we're supposed to search and seek out the wisdom and knowledge of God, and all
Good
the
stuff.
Rest will be at.
I
now,
like
what
wisdom.
We understand, see, we'll give Solomon a little credit today, but yet we'll take some away too, because the preparations of the heart and the answer
yes.
of the tongue are from the Lord. So when God
yes.
asked Solomon what he would like, and he could ask
wisdom.
For anything, he asked for wisdom. So we understand that God put that in his heart to ask. Because
mm-hmm.
just like Jeremiah said, not a word on my tongue that you don't know altogether. So we get Solomon, and what did he say? I want some wisdom and knowledge. And so the first thing Jesus says is seek the kingdom and get the wisdom and knowledge of God. And yet,
Hallelujah.
Everybody,
Amen.
They overlook what it clearly says, that the wisdom
mm-hmm.
and knowledge of God is found in Proverbs. And in the first five verses, we see this. It says,
mm-hmm.
here's the Proverbs of Solomon, to know wisdom and instruction, to perceive the words of understanding, to receive the instruction of wisdom, justice, judgment, and equity, to give some to the young man knowledge and discretion. A wise man will hear and increase in learning, and a man of understanding to attain to wise counsel. Well, I understand that the word of God is a lamp for my feet and a light for my path.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes. Amen, praise God.
The subtle will bring subtlety to the simple.
Yes.
His word brings that to us. So
okay.
here it is, to give subtlety to the simple. And here we are talking about God, and God is more important than anything else. And if we love God with all that we are, like we're commanded to, then we'll always have time for God. We're not going to go sell property, go get married, or go do whatever those other people were doing when they were invited to the wedding feast. Because we love God, we got time for him all the time. And when God
okay.
comes into the room, there you go.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay,
brother,
now,
praise
Facebook,
God.
I'm on Facebook, and I share his word all day long, every day, faith to faith to faith, hearing
yes.
from, and you're all welcome. I love you all. You're all good people. I hear it in your hearts and in your voices. I Thank you for inviting.
Praise God.
Yes.
Brother, likewise.
I had
peace, love, and light.
I just acknowledge the geography. United States listeners is 89.7%. 89.7% United States.
Praise God.
Right, yes. Okay, in Cameroon, her name or his name is Rabu. Happy to 2022. What can you suggest on how to change for a better living as a Christian? Pastor Agapito. What can you suggest on how to change for a better living as a Christian? Pastor Agapito? Pastor, can you hear me? She
right
said, she said just on how to change for a better living as a Christian.
It's in Proverbs.
You're being cutting off.
Yeah, I've been cutting
you
off? Okay. Okay,
yeah.
What about this? Can you hear me better right
now? Yeah, I can hear you. I can hear
okay. Yes, yeah, she said, what can you suggest on how to change for a better living as a Christian?
What are the ways, he said, she said?
No, what is your suggestion on how to change for a better living as a Christian?
Oh, what are you looking for? You know, like as the brother said, that, you know, in the presence of the Lord, there is joy and peace. And everything that you think about Jesus, you know, you worship him because... We worship him because it's not for the things that he just gave to us materially, but, you know, all the joy and peace and love, you know, is more than money or more than material thing, you know, in this world. So if you cannot find that,
amen,
you will always look for something. We really have to find, you know, we really have to have Jesus in our heart. That's when you have all the contentment. When there is a question of contentment, that means we are not really close to him. You know, we have to, he draws us closer. You know, he draws us closer, but we have to do our own volition. You know, like the free will, we have to choose him, make him number one in your life, and that is
amen.
When you will be complete.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. So I have this I have this from Virginia Rose. Do not say New Year's resolution if you cannot fulfill. For these are like promises that made to be broken. To me, I promised not to smoke again, and I found out I'm smoking again. This happened last year. Okay, we're ready to tackle that. Okay, we're ready to tackle that.
You
got it. Yeah, we're ready to tackle
that.
That
was
just
found on the south sideline.
So, Puerto
you know,
Rico,
what we
Ray
need
Naldo.
To learn how to do in 2022 is to love our enemies. God said
okay.
He loved
praise
us first
God.
Life.
Hallelujah.
And so it seems like he ought to be a great leader. He is, and we follow the example of a great leader. He said, you love me now because I loved you first. And he says that we should pray for our enemies. And, you know, most men would ask, well, why would I do that? What would be my reward? And they always seek a reward. But properly, when we look at it in the context of the Spirit, we see that when we are enemy, we're doing what God said to do, following his example that we love him now because he loved us first. So we ask for our enemies to be taught by God how to love us the way he taught us how to love them. And that is how you pray for your enemies. And you pray for them and you say, Father, teach them how to love me, just like you taught me how to love them. And then we get rid of our enemies because he says that if a man's ways pleases the Lord, he'll make his enemies lie down at peace with him. So
who
in
are
2022,
your enemies? sometimes we are ourselves our enemies. Our spouses are enemies sometimes.
Well, exactly. But you know what? You pray for God to teach them, and they will know what we know, and they won't bother you like they used to.
Yes.
And he says he'll make them lie down in peace with you. So we say, blessed is our Father who has placed all our enemies into our hands.
We
and then the next word that
week.
We understand.
Richard, Brother Richard.
We need to also understand that God sent his son into the world to save it because he loved the world. And we see in 1 Timothy chapter 2, it says, therefore, I exhort you to all prayers and all supplications should be made for all men, not anybody left behind.
Yes,
because mercy requires empathy, and empathy gives mercy right back, and that's where you forgive. And all men are forgiven by the mercy of God. And when we understand that, then we pray for all. And what did God want? Well, Timothy continues on that the prayer, or not Timothy, but Paul to Timothy, he says all prayers and all supplications for all men, kings and all people in authority, for this is good and acceptable to God our Savior, who will have all men be saved and come to the knowledge of his truth. And this young lady prior, the evangelist, what's your name, evangelist? Because I like you. I like
Jacqueline.
What you're saying.
Praise
Jacqueline.
God.
Jacqueline.
And
okay.
Simon, and it's a pleasure to meet you.
Well, Jacqueline,
I have a question for you. What about Samson and Delilah? Delilah was the enemy.
Well, we're not concerned about Samson and Delilah, because what we got to understand is in Proverbs 16:4, he says, I create a wicked man for the day of evil. Isaiah 45:7, I create light, I create peace, I create darkness,
hallelujah.
I create evil. And
if
he does all these things, then we understand that the wicked guy is, like he said, have not the potter the right to make one vessel for honor and one for dishonor? Have I not the right to do what I want? And he uses the bad guy to afflict us. So we need to pray for them. And it says that he will have all men be saved. And the sister before, she said that all tongues will swear and all knees will bow. And he said, I swear by myself because there is no other. And so when we understand
that, Brother Richard, we have to move on.
And we have the love of God. If we pray for all and we say, Father, we ask that all men be saved and come to the knowledge of your truth.
Amen.
And Jesus
says,
whatever you ask, you can have it. And if you love God
hallelujah.
And you know he wants the world to be saved, I'll guarantee you that'll fill your joy when you understand that prayer of faith that Abella's made.
Praise God.
Because
yes, Lord.
Man has sinned, the Father forgives, and when he's got the wrong idea, he heals his mind. And that's what we got to do in 2022. Sorry,
okay,
yes,
let's
Lord.
Move on.
Yes.
Okay, let's go to Puerto Rico. We only have 15 minutes left. 15. We're going to move on. I'm sorry. Puerto Rico, Rinaldo. Happy New Year. God bless us. People want to change, but they don't want to change because they choose not to change. Pastor Agapito. Pastor Agapito.
Yes, that's why the Lord has given us the gift of free will. So we will be rewarded by our obedience, and there is also a consequence of disobedience. So, you know, the number one thing we do is to pray for people. Pray for that spirit of disobedience.
Well, affliction drives
us to
God, so it's a good thing.
And we have to show the love that even though, you know, there are people who that I encountered in the past or, you know, they're really challenged. They're not... they're not enemies, but because the Lord told us to love our enemies. Enemies is not, it's those people who doesn't worship God the way in spirit and in truth. So since we were once sinners, right? So he died for us.
Amen.
Because while we were yet sinners. So I remember every time, you know, that I was saved from my sins. So I have to be compassionate also for those who manifest those kind of spirits. And every day, it's a challenge. It's a challenge. We don't disown them. Even though they don't
praise
like
God.
Us, you know, they go away. They go away, but
well,
still,
let's all
the
pray
prayer.
For them all. For
the
all
prayer
of them.
Is not.
They're all going to be
saved.
God's going to save them. It's his purpose. And he says, whatever I
we
thought,
have,
whatever I purpose, it's going to come to pass.
Very
hallelujah.
Like prayer,
praise God.
The prayer of the righteous avails much. So the Lord wants
Amen.
Us to pray for them. Amen.
That's
hallelujah,
right.
Brothers
so
and
what
sisters.
Do we do?
Amen.
We pray for them to be taught how to love us the way we were taught how to love them.
Yeah.
We teach them
yes,
to
Lord.
Love God with all their heart so they'll go to the Word to find out all they can about him. So they'll fill
yes.
up on the Spirit. They want to be spiritually filled, but the Word is the Spirit.
Hallelujah.
He is God.
Praise God.
And you want to fill up on the Spirit, all you got to do is have a little faith, because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. And when we hear something, we hear it, and James even knew it. He said, you ask, but you don't get, do you? Why?
There is also the word of Jesus, unless Jesus Christ drove them to the Father. That's why we all Christians, as Christians, you know, we submit to that word of the Lord when he says, unless I drove them to me, you know, you can't do anything. So,
Amen. Where the word is a light in the world of darkness, and if we lift up the light, all the little bugs will fly out of the darkness to come to the light, won't they? Because that's
Amen.
What it's all about.
Praise God. This little light on mine, let it shine, brothers and sisters. Let it shine.
Okay.
That's right. The darker
Hallelujah.
The night, the smaller the light, the brighter it is.
Okay, Amen. We move on, guys. We move to Nigeria. His name is Awondo. I asked this show to pay for. We need money. He said,
yeah,
I asked
but it's always about money when it should be just about God.
Hold on, well, let me read it, brother. Let me read it. Let me say. Okay, I asked this show to. We need money. We are poor family. It would be nice if you can donate Cash App 20622. I think you're in the wrong show, brother. This is not like a charity show, but I think you're in a wrong show. So,
Amen.
I look at Psalm 37, verse 25, and it says there that I've been young and now I'm old, but I've never seen a righteous man nor his children begging for bread.
Begging for bread. Praise God.
He's from Nigeria. We just pray for him, okay? Now we
Amen.
Go to Australia.
Well, we already have, if everybody will pray for all to be saved and come to the knowledge of his truth. Well, that's up to God now to open their eyes. But
okay,
we ask God, he knows we ask him for what he wanted.
Thank you so much for just leading and allowing everybody.
Okay, Pastor Danny is about to lead. Okay, Pastor Danny, you're leading now? You're going to church now, Pastor Danny?
Yes, thank you so much.
Yes, doctor. Thank you, doctor.
To hear everyone, and again, Happy New Year, and you're doing great job. Thank you so much for what you're doing for the kingdom, and just wishing each and every one, Brother Richard, and you ladies are awesome, and thank you so much. Participate, everyone.
Happy New Year.
So
Happy New Year to you.
May God continue to bless you. Keep the loving arms around you. Yes, Lord. Protect you from seen and unseen danger. Oh, just beautiful. 2022.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Click the link after 5 minutes after the show, and it goes to the replay. Click the link of the show, and it goes to the replay, okay? Happy New Year, Dr. Danny.
Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
We have 10 minutes. Australia, Jim. He says, Happy New Year. If you want to be a successful person this 2022, stay in with Jesus. He will not fail you. Amen to that. Amen to that. I like that. Amen to that. Okay.
Amen.
San Francisco, California. Happy New Year. Just
look me up on Facebook.
Yes.
I will. Definitely will. Praise God.
Okay. San Francisco, California. Rob, say peace and love to you all. Hallelujah. Okay.
Thank you, Jesus.
Switzerland, Riza, Happy New Year. Love one another this 2022. Christ says so. Love your enemies and pray for them. That's what the Brother Richard was just saying. Yes. We do.
The same prayer that you would want
for
your family.
It is to do. Teach them how to love
Amen.
Us the way you taught us to love them. That's pretty simple.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. ABC 1, 2, 3.
United Kingdom, Joe. United Kingdom, Joe. Happy New Year, America, all over the world. Get drunk, stay safe, be good, live soberly. That's the Christian advice I can give. Thank you, Brother Joe.
Praise
from,
God. Thank you.
From United Kingdom. South Dakota, Lisa, Happy New Year radio talk show. Be ready for brothers and sisters. Jesus is coming soon. Okay, do you agree that? Amen. Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Oh, you, here we go, guys. California, Carl. She said, I'm responding to the girl from Malaysia. My daughter. Whoa.
What?
She said, my email address is carl65@yahoo.com. carl65@yahoo.com. Again, yeah, Malaysia said, Su Bingwa. So there's one in California, Carl. His name is Carl. I'm responding to you from my, you might be my daughter. My email is carl65@yahoo.com. We should give a big hand for
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. They can be connected with radio show. Hallelujah. Georgia, Rick, let all pray that God 2022. It's nothing but the work of the devil. Hallelujah. Okay. Pastor Raquel.
The heart is deceitful above all things. So if that's the case, then the devil doesn't matter, because our heart, out of it, comes all the issues of life. And it's deceitful above all things. So we don't even want to even bring up a devil. Because if the best he could ever be is in second place.
Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm, come on, somebody.
The best he could ever be.
Amen.
Yes. Yes. Amen. Amen.
So let's get away from trying to blame somebody but ourselves for our own problems.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
But
if, praise
but
God.
But if the COVID, we have to pray for this COVID.
Well, because of the COVID, we don't really have to do anything. Because we don't have to be afraid of the COVID. But if we're going to follow the world, we're going to have to follow their command. But if we're
going
to follow on God, we're going to go forward without fear.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
That's not giving us
the
fear.
Hey, the Omicron can be as big as a grapefruit, remember? Oh, the grapefruit is the size of the grapefruit. We can take it. And everybody said, no, we're it. But guess what?
But
we can. And right now, the Omicron variant has become the mildest one of all. And the earth created, we were created from the earth. The earth is not going to kill us off.
Yes.
And so
but we have 5 minutes.
No fear about COVID.
Hallelujah. You have too much things to share, brother. But we have 5 minutes.
Powerful.
But we really need to have a prayer tonight before New Year's Eve. So...
we need to pray for all men to be saved and know it's real and quit worrying about people going to hell. And that is the problem right there.
Who wants to pray?
Amen.
What can you advise? Okay, last word. Last thought. What can you advise to the world to this 2022? Okay, go ahead, Brother Richard. Last word. Last thought, please.
My advice is the best thing you can do for the world is read your Bible and understand that God is not in there to forgive you. He's in there to tell you you never had anything wrong with you.
Yes.
He said, out
Praise
of the mouth
God.
Of the man comes your defilement, but you don't get defiled by what goes in. And we eat the word, it goes in, and you'll never be defiled by it.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
God. Glory, hallelujah.
Pastor Raquel.
I want to quote John chapter 3 verse John chapter 6 verse 33. He said, in this world you will have trials and tribulations, but be of good cheer. Jesus said, I have overcome the world. John,
yes,
amen.
We overcome by 33. Faith. We overcome by faith.
Amen.
Evangelist.
And
any last way to the world for 2022? Advice.
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, and whosoever believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. And we are the whosoever. So whosoever don't believe, look, this is your opportunity to start a new year. It's a blank page. Okay. And whatever you look, the next page will be is what you put on it. So let it be everything that God said on it and ordained you. You know, nothing but the best.
Amen. Amen.
And like the brother said, go to Proverbs and look, keep his faith, his kingdom, his wisdom,
and knowledge, and in everything get an understanding. Get your own personal relationship with him. Oh, my God. Yes.
Okay, from you, my advice to the world is that a lot of people like prosperity, but it's only found in Matthew 32:3. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. That is the key. That is the key.
Hallelujah.
Anyone wants to
Let
pray?
Let me throw this in there real quick. We were talking about prosperity, so we'll go back to that, because Jesus said, the man that believes in me, out of his belly will flow rivers of living water.
Oh,
and remember,
yes.
the planet beside
yes.
those rivers are streams of life that bear
yes.
fruit in all seasons to heal the nation.
Yes.
So get that seed planted in you and grow a tree and feed the
yes.
world the tree of life. And
yes.
that's what we can do.
Hallelujah. Okay. Anybody
Amen.
Wants to pray?
Yes, Lord.
Anybody wants to pray for this new year as we live together and we depart each other as brothers in Christ? Anybody wants to pray? Anyone?
I would like to do
Come on.
Stuff, since I like to talk anyway, but I want to add, this is all we need to ask. Father, we
Praise
ask
God.
For your will alone and nothing more. Let it go
nothing
and let
more.
It be so.
Yes.
That's
Hallelujah.
Right, because we trust you.
Yes.
We don't need to but, tell you anything. We know what we need before we even know we need it. So we're not going to waste
Amen.
Your time with
yes.
the Lord. Have with
yes.
us
yes,
the
Lord.
Way that you will and do with us what you will.
Yes, Lord.
Okay, what about you, Pastor?
Thank you, Jesus.
Pray?
And we thank you in
pray,
advance,
Pastor?
Lord.
Pastor Raquel, do you want to pray? Pastor
yeah,
Raquel, do you want to pray?
Prayer. I just want to claim.
Yes.
I just want to claim.
Yes.
That it says that he can do beyond what we can ask for, and he we believe that, and we just thank you for it, Lord. We thank you for your
yes.
wonderful God, and Lord, we cannot even fathom, oh Lord God, who you are. We know that you are close to us, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you are going, oh Lord, to make people understand who you are, and it's you who will do it because you did it to us, oh Lord God. So we claim for every soul of man that you're going to reveal yourself also tonight, this new year, oh Lord God, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Evangelist.
Yes, Lord.
Evangelist. Okay.
All the gifts
yes,
and callings come without
Evangelist.
Repentance.
Evangelist,
I just want to thank God. Yes, I just want to thank God and for all he has done for the whole world, you know, for 2021. And I want to thank him in advance for what he's going to do in 2022. And just praise him. Just he that keep his mind on the Lord, even when we're living in a world with so much confusion, hatred and all
faith.
That stuff, we'll have the peace that God give. You know, just
yes.
keep your mind on the Lord and walk in faith. You understand that faith, the
That's
size
right.
of a grain of a mustard seed, no matter what it looks like, no matter what it feels like, look, just trust God. Look, whatever he brings
yes.
you to, he will bring you through. Praise God. That's all I can
Hallelujah.
Say. You can't go wrong.
Yes. Okay. I want to thank
hand,
everyone.
We don't have him dragging him.
yes. I want to thank everyone who participated in the show. I want to thank everybody who participated in the show. Dr. Danny Sanova, who just left to go to church. Dr. Raquel Agapito from New York and New Jersey. Thank you, ma'am. Brother Richard, those are brilliant thoughts and verses. Thank you for stopping by. And, of course, Evangelist Jacqueline, thank you for stopping by. I want to thank
You're
our
more than
sponsors
welcome.
Again of the show. I want to thank the sponsors of the show again. Phil, thank you. Thank you for sponsoring the show. Planet Fitness, AutoZone, Wendy's Hamburger, City Security Alarm System, Beach Network, Senior Life Insurance, GoToAlwaysSend.com, my sponsor, my endorser, GoToAlwaysSend.com, and also Bell Taco. Sponsor of the show, write me to Baby Sub Show, P.O. Box 40921, Bakersfield, California. Again, Baby Sub Show, P.O. Box 40921, Bakersfield, California, 93384. Baby Sub would like to give acknowledge and give a free perfume to those who participated here on the show. And so the T-shirt is, if you want to order some T-shirt to me, not order, but I give free to those who are guests. on this show. Also, I'm giving free perfumes until January 2nd only. Baby Shed perfume. And also, I would like to acknowledge those who ordered Miracle Pen. I just shipped like 7 pens this week. Thank you so much for having Baby Seve Ministry. So now look at geography. South and North Africa, 15% are listening. South and North Africa, 15%. India, Indonesia, Saudi Arabia, Dubai, Singapore, 20% are listening. Cambodia, 15%. Malaysia, 22%. Malaysia, 22%. India, 2%. Germany, London, 15%. Canada, 20%. 20% listening. Ghana, Zimbabwe, Zambia, Cameroon, Nigeria, Pakistan, 17% listening. Australia, 25% listening. Australia, United States, 89.8% are listening. 89.8% are listeners. Yes. Happy New Year to everyone. And God bless you. And here's a song for me and Brother Doyle. It's now available for all major music platforms. It's stream it for 99 cents. Gloria to me and Brother Doyle on the song. But I want to thank everyone again for stopping by. Sorry, Phil Agapito, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Pastora, for being here. Okay, thank you, Brother Richard. Thank you, Brother Richard.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you for inviting me.
Jacqueline.
You're welcome. Okay. Always.
Stay safe.
It's a pleasure to meet all of my brothers and sisters.
Be responsible. Don't get drunk, okay? God bless you. And here's Brother Doyle and me on Glorious. It's now a major music platform. Happy New Year, America. Happy New Year, Asia. Happy New Year, Europe. Happy New Year, Africa. For the world. Thank you for tuning in. Baby Seve World Christian Show. Hallelujah. Happy New Year.